today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Slovakia, hosting biathlon and the Nordic competitions, and Spain, holding the other snow competitions in the Sierra Nevada and the ice sports in Granada. Altogether, almost 1,600 student athletes competed, and we'll look at some of the most remarkable performances. We'll talk with Vladimir Zagravsky, who wrote a page of history, and Victoria Parial, who never gives up. We meet Mark Oliveres, a man of determination, and the talented Patricia Kummer. Both would celebrate success. And finally, the man who almost quit but stayed on to win, and the inspiring story of the underdogs in ice hockey. Strepska Plesa in the Tatra Mountains. This is where Vladimir Zagravsky of Bulgaria celebrated the most important victory of his career. The ski jumper, helped by his father and coach, snatched the gold medal and opened a new chapter in ski jumping for his country. It was important not only for me, but also for Bulgaria, because it was the second medal in winter sport. And it's also important for ski jumping, because it's becoming more and more popular. The 21-year-old sports student has World Cup experience, and he knew he had a chance of winning. In round one, Zagravsky made an excellent jump of 95 meters, certainly better than in practice, because he followed the advice of the FISU technical delegate, Austria's Paul Ganzenhuber. I gave him some tips because I saw him in practice, and he made some mistakes that he could easily correct. And I told him if he did that, he could finish first. And he's won today because he's done everything right. Zagravsky had been doing a lot of his training in Austria, and that helped. Now he needed to stay mentally focused before that final round. With 94 meters this time and a total of 248.8, Zagravsky was the number one, ahead of the Russian duo Ilmir Hazatdinov and Evgeny Klimov. It's really very nice, you know, because over the last 2 years I had problems with my shape. It was getting worse. And now it's getting better, so we'll see. But for me, it was a great day.
And gold medal.
A great day for his coach as well, the former Olympic ski jumper Emil Zagravsky, proud of the performance of his son. My father was a ski jumper. 12 years ago, it was in Samokov, and they had a small hill there, a hill of some 40 meters. And there my father started his career as a ski jumping coach. And one day, he came up to me and said, "If you want, you can come and have a look." And that's when everything started. Junior world champion in 2011, frequently in the World Cup top 20, his best World Cup season was 2 years ago, before a back injury slowed his progress. But Vladimir knows that he can count on the support of his father always. We have some problems together sometimes, but we can also work together in a very good manner. And he helps me a lot in my sport, certainly. Yes, I have to thank my father. Vladimir wrote not only a little bit of history for his country, he also wrote another chapter in the sporting saga of his family. I'm a very dedicated athlete. I love my sport. I'm doing everything for my passion, biathlon. And I worked hard to be here.
J'ai fait beaucoup de choses pour arriver ici. des moments très
there are some
doux,
difficult moments and some delightful moments.
Aussi.
An event like the Universiade is very important for us to value our work as athletes and as students. It's very important for me to represent my country and the values of the students as well. Her name is Victoria Parial. She's a Spanish biathlete from Granada, competing at the Winter Universiade in Slovakia. A 26-year-old student has had to struggle to follow her dream of being an athlete in a country where she doesn't have a lot of support.
Victoria
is physically no better than other athletes. She's rather an average athlete physically, but she has strength of character. She's especially consistent at a high level. She's always giving herself challenges, and even if she fails, she wants to go further, higher, always. Victoria started with cross country, then she discovered biathlon just a few years ago. But training for biathlon in the south of Spain, in Andalusia, is quite a challenge. To win a medal in this sport requires so much, and it's almost impossible. It really is difficult. But we made it last year. In fact, we got three medals, one at the Summer World Championships and two others at the European Championships. She was runner-up twice in the sprint and the pursuit. But it really is a challenge, because Victoria started in biathlon only in 2008, which means she started at the age of 19. Since 2008, during competitions, Alexandra Napa has worked from 6 o'clock in the morning until 11 at night, always available to prepare the equipment and to coach Victoria. And he works without assistance.
We'll
never be like the Norwegians with a lot of technicians, or like the Austrians and the Russians who have 30 or 35 technicians for just four athletes taking part. And you can imagine if there are 35 people, it tells you there's a lot of work to do in terms of the preparation of the skis, the physical preparation of the athlete. It's a sport like Formula One where you can win it in the paddock.
C'est un sport qui se gagne aussi dans le paddock comme en Formule 1.
At the psychological level, it's difficult to be just a two-person team doing a lot of work, because biathlon is a very technical sport. Victoria Parial came to the University Games with a lot of ambition. Her strength is normally the shooting, but this time, during the 15-kilometer race, she skied fast but missed with the rifle six times and finished 17th, well behind the winner, Alina Rykova from Kazakhstan. But there was a reason for her underperformance. We've just competed in the sprint at the Biathlon World Cup at Antholz. Right afterwards, we took the car to come here. A 10-hour drive, and you know, I'm tired. Victoria was disappointed. She expected much more from her first Winter Universiade competition. We didn't have enough time to prepare the kit. I had no time to practice here, but okay, there are still three races to come. The next day, the Spanish sports student was on the shooting range, working with a rifle, practicing to be fast, to move smoothly, to freeze before pulling the trigger, to be accurate. Victoria was determined to do better in the next race. She's really going to go for it, you know, and she wants to make amends because she didn't succeed in the individual race. She will want to prove that the medals of last year were not won by luck. And you know, I think she's got a lot of fighting spirit that'll make her grow wings, if you like. And I think it's going to work for her. It was the 7.5-kilometer sprint, and the local heroine, Alina Fialkova, was in great shape. And Victoria, well, despite all that practice, she had 10 misses in the shooting, and she'd finish down in 35th place. 3 minutes 35 behind Fialkova, her problems continued. In the pursuit, Victoria would come 17th behind the Russian winner, Evgenia Pavlova. And in the 12.5-kilometer mass start, she was well behind the Czech winner, Jitka Landová. 14th place for Victoria this time, the best results. The others help you in giving you that necessary motivation day by day, every day.
La motivation de les jours, tous les jours.
And certainly, her optimism is undimmed. Supported by her family and by her coach, she's trying to combine the physical and the academic demands as best she can.
At
Granada University, it's not easy, you know, because there's not a special program to help top-level athletes. But I think the difficulties there have helped me really to become stronger mentally and to battle harder, to get to a higher standard. Because the path to get there is definitely not an easy one. Being self-financed for the past 4 years, the team of two will continue to strive. And after the Universiade, while Victoria continues her studies, their next challenge is to be part of the top 30 in the Biathlon World Cup. You're watching Campus Sport, and coming next, the alpine skier winning a medal against all the odds, and the fierce but friendly rivalry of two snowboarders in just a moment.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Calm. It's the Super G. It's your first race. And whatever you do, it's going to be fine. I was a little bit nervous at the beginning, and you get a little bit more nervous because it is the first race. So for me, it was a surprise. If you look coldly at the summer you've spent, the preparation you've had, well, it wasn't very much, you could say. So just to be here at all is not bad. At the Winter University Games, Marc Oliveiras was trying to make history by winning a medal for the tiny Pyrenean Principality of Andorra. But it was something of a miracle that he was able to take part at all after what happened to him last summer. I didn't feel good. I felt wrong. I felt very wrong in the hands and the feet. I woke up in the morning with a really high pulse, and I told myself, this isn't normal. What's happening here? It's bizarre. And I also had marks on my skin. So I went to have some tests taken by the Federation's doctor. And finally, the analyses came through, and they came out positive for lupus, an autoimmune disease. And yeah, it's been hard, a little bit hard. Lupus can attack the victim's vital organs, and one of Mark's kidneys has been affected. It was completely unexpected. I was with the doctor, and I didn't know what it was. At the beginning, they told me, the sun mustn't touch you. And that's when you say to yourself, how am I going to cope? You start to ask questions, all that sort of thing. At the beginning, it was a very sudden change, and for me, it was a bit hard because I was at home, not able to do anything, and it was so hard. It's hard to come back. But Mark would come back. He continued to ski within authorized limits. His challenge was to be able to ski with more strength and with less effort.
Je
I have to be careful about my workload. I have to go a little more smoothly. For example, if the others are doing a series of something four or five times, for me, it'll be three or four. If they do 2 hours of skiing for me, 1 hour 30 and so on. If I need 2 or 3 days of rest, well, I have to take them. It's what my body needs. His worst enemy is the sun, and Mark is taking no risks. He waited for the medical authorization before committing finally to these university games. I had some tests 1 month before coming here, and I had the results 2 weeks after that. The analyses came out really well. There were two or three things that weren't so good, but it was just a week before coming here that they said, you can go. So we decided to come. For Mark, the Universiade was a new lease of life. When I'm at the start, I don't know why, but I believe that I unplug a little bit more than last year. I don't know why it's like that, but I feel more relaxed. I think I'm more spontaneous as well. I have no benchmark for this competition at all. I came out really aggressively. I felt strong. And I thought to myself, okay, I'm going to give this everything I can. And the feeling was really good. Well, I made two or three mistakes. There was a turn where I slipped and touched a gate, but it didn't stop me from continuing the race. And getting down towards the bottom, I made a big mistake on the jump. And in my head, I said to myself, uh-oh, either you're totally out of control, and that's why you've made mistakes, or you're really, really fast, and that's why you've made mistakes. And that was it. And at the finish, I knew I was fast. And when I saw my time, I was so happy. Very surprised, too. And after that, when the race is over, you say, damn it, yeah, that's really good. This is the first medal. You've come back, you could say, from injury. And for me, it really was really good. A moment of joy. Yeah. Mark missed the gold by 1/100 of a second. But the records will show that he won his country's first medal in the Winter Universiades. And quite a story it was. At the University Games, two female Olympic champions were in the lineup. One from the parallel slalom, the other from the parallel giant slalom. Two friends and rivals about to go head-to-head once more. It was just the same at the last Universiade. There's always a high standard with the World Cup competitors at the start. But it's really fun, and getting a medal here means so much, you know. It's a lot of fun to compete against each other. You know that you have to push hard. Of course, it's something quite special that we like to practice and compete together. And we appreciate each other a lot. The competition was held in the Sierra Nevada with a snowpark that features the longest course in Europe. But how different is it from Monte Bondone, where the last Universiade was held at Trentino in Italy? Maybe this time it'll be a little bit more technical. Last time the visibility was bad, I remember. We couldn't take many risks. I think this time it's on a large hill, so I don't know whether we'll have to make tight turns or not. Of course, you can't tell beforehand. But I think I can manage the races all right. The two athletes here may be rivals, but the rivalry is good-natured, and they're used to competing against each other. Yeah, we've known each other for a long time. We're the same age. We've competed together in so many races, and it's really enjoyable. She's such a good person, too. And speaking with her during competitions is really interesting. Patrizia Kummer is ready for the final. I really love the feeling just before the race. I'm ready for the competition. I think it's going to be great fun. And I'll approach it like every other competition, going flat out to be with the best.
Ich gehe jedes Weltcuprennen einfach Vollgas und versuchen ganz vorne mitzufahren.
Unfortunately, no Julia Dzumowicz. She's been disqualified in the first round. But now, Patricia Kummer will race to victory, beating Germany's Selina Jörg and Nadia Ochner of Italy. Kummer taking the Universiad title at the third attempt.
I'm mega glücklich. Ich kann's
I'm mega
fassen,
happy.
Weil,
I can't believe it, really, because
ja,
I've competed twice before. First I was seventh, then fourth. So I said to myself, it's always like minus three. And that means next time I can win it. And it happened. I'm so glad. Patricia Kummer, now the queen of the Olympic and the University Games. Still to come on Campus Sport, the man who almost quit and was glad he didn't. And the happy underdogs of ice hockey in just a moment.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Well-deserved massage for the best Nordic combined athlete of the Winter Universiade in Slovakia. Adam Cisla won the two individual titles at Strzepska Plesa, but the Polish student had to fight hard for it. So what finally was the key to victory? I managed to stay calm at the beginning of the event to demonstrate my mental strength. I think that was the reason I was able to win.
Trzeba robić na tyle, ile się w danym momencie wie, ile można, żeby nie przedobrzeć.
So Cisla now adds these medals to another two golds and the silver he won at the Universiad 2 years ago in Trentino. And now the reward after the rigors of competition.
Jestem bardzo zadowolony.
I couldn't feel better. I simply did my job and got the medals. But before coming to the Universiade, Adam doubted his ability. He hadn't even been sure about continuing his career. Now he was lying third after the ski jump, and in the 10-kilometer cross-country race, he battled with David Velder of Germany for the victory. It was an extraordinary finish. Cisla making it home by a margin of 2 centimeters over Velder. I'm so surprised at what I've done, surprised that I could find the necessary energy for those final meters. Well, the defending champion may have been surprised, but his coach wasn't. He had faith in Adam's qualities.
I think mentality and also this his character, because Nordic combiner have to have a really strong character to fight on cross-country race, and also when he's coming down from gate, he must keep this pressure, and Adam is for me like completed in these two sides, and this is also his secret, that he is fighter.
Cisla felt his shape was back. The second event began with the cross-country, a 10-kilometer mass start. Cisla finishing behind Velder and Samir Mastiev of Russia. But the silver medalist from Trentino would push for the victory on the ski jump. Technical problems on the hill delayed the start of that competition. Adam knowing that if he wanted a good performance, his skis had to be perfectly prepared and he'd have to stay absolutely focused. But the physical education student from the University of Warsaw did what he had to do. A score of 216.9 and Cisla taking the victory ahead of Velder and his Polish teammate, Matthias Wantulak. The Universiade was a decisive episode in his career. These university games have given me a lot of confidence, and they've also shown me you have to be patient if you want to be victorious. The event really gave me so much. Now the holder of 4 Universiade titles, Adam Cisla is no longer lacking the motivation to continue his career, and who knows what new heights he may reach in competitions to come. In terms of multidisciplinary tournaments, the Universiad is the world's number two after the Olympics. And in ice hockey, for the players of the 11 teams who gathered at Granada in Spain, these university games provided a great stage for their talents.
I think it's really important tournament for everybody in there because we are students and this is the part of our career and we can make maybe some steps in the future.
For many of these students, ice hockey is a priority for the future, especially in the major hockey nations like Russia, United States and Canada.
At every level in our country, it's the number one sport. Our kids grow up playing hockey and then they all hope to play for Canada's team at one time or the NHL.
Under the gaze of the Swedish team in the final of the Universiad, Russia would beat Kazakhstan by 3-1. But it wasn't so much the score the Swedes were interested in as the strength and style of the players.
Well, if you look at the, how we train, how we live, we're part-time hockey players, mostly students. There is a big, big difference if you look at player by player. And if you look at team by team, they have quite other resources. They have gone through a lot of more stages than the players have here. Many of the guys here, they said like, maybe I don't want to be to do everything about my life should be hockey. So we went to school.
But for 2 weeks, the Swedish players lived a different life from normal. They lived to the rhythm of an elite team, and they lived to a very precise schedule, including hours of studying, because the players are, first and foremost, students, called to high academic studies.
Everyone is students, actually. Many study engineering. Last time we were in Trentino, everybody was engineers, and this time is a mix. But most of the players are engineers, students, and we also have economics students and other kind of studies.
In the Universiad, the Swedish team is a special case. Even though Sweden is one of the strongest nations in ice hockey, until 2010, university hockey barely existed. The students had to take matters into their own hands.
We haven't mentioned to create some university hockey league, and that's why I find something missing here. So I took the opportunity to actually create the league. And I think and I hope that the Ice Hockey Association in Sweden will take this as a good start. And, you know, it's very important because this national university team is one very big reason to keep, you know, continue to playing your sport, ice hockey, and to participating in UHL when you start studying in some university in Sweden, because you always want to play for a national team.
It took the creation of the University League by the students themselves to finally return Sweden to the Universiad in 2013 after an absence of 45 years. And still, the players have to make sacrifices.
You know, all the players here are actually paying for themselves, so it's also, it's not just to pick the players who actually are the best one. You have to pick the one who actually can come here and pay for themselves, and mostly by our staff, team staff.
In Sweden, the UHL is a non-profit organization. These are players who organize the games, the sale of the tickets, the search for sponsors, and the functioning of the league. And they came to the university games in Spain without much preparation.
We just had one training before going to Spain, and here we have two and three trainings before the first game against Russia. So that's not so much preparation, but most of the players are coming from UHL, our university league back in Sweden, so they know each other pretty much.
Joakim Thompson is the founder of the Swedish University League, and here in Granada, he was the captain of the team that notched up 3 wins against Korea, Spain and China, and 3 defeats against Russia, Canada and the USA. No surprise about those defeats.
It's very fun. It's tough, but it's fun because, you know, many players here are playing in KHL and VHL. So these are very, very good players, and that's, of course, very, very fun and, you know, exciting to try to beat some of those guys.
So no medals for Team Sweden, but they enjoyed their time at the university games, the camaraderie and the learning curve. before returning to their academic work back home with renewed vigor.
It's a very good competition because this is Olympic Games for students sports. So it's the best you can play if you're a college hockey guy.
And that was Campus Sport.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,